So we are just going to deal with the continuous random variable. And first we need to conceptually define what a continuous random variable is. The continuous random variables can take a continuum of possible values, right? So the number of possible values that it can take are uncountably many. Basically, it can take real values, usually defined as an interval over the real line. If we want to speak generally, of course, we can theoretically say that any continuous random variable can be defined over all real numbers. And continuous random variables are usually modeled with their probability density functions, which is abbreviated as PDF. And it is denoted by function F. And how do we use that function F to calculate probabilities? First of all, for continuous random variables, we cannot talk about equation probabilities. So, unlikely to discrete random variables, a continuous random variable cannot probably be equal to a certain value. What we can talk about the continuous random variables is the interval probability. So, we can only talk about the probability of a continuous random variable to reside between two values such as A and B. Or we can talk about less than or equal to or greater than or equal to probabilities. So not necessarily these intervals should be bounded. They may not be bounded as well. So what is the probability of a continuous random variable to be within the interval A and B? We calculate such probability by integrating the probability density function between A and B. Now, the probability density functions are non-negative functions, and the total area under a probability density function will be always equal to 1. And for a certain interval such as A and B, the area under the probability density function in that region gives us the probability of that random variable to reside between A and B. Now, as we have said, if you calculate the integral of the PDF from minus infinity to plus infinity, you will be calculating the total area under the PDF, and it is always going to be equal to 1. That is the important property of PDF. And as we have said, we cannot talk about equation probabilities for continuous random variables, as when we integrate the PDF with the same lower bound and upper bound, the integral will yield a zero value. And as a consequence, whether you are calculating the probability of a closed interval or an open interval, or one side closed, other side open interval, or vice versa, it does not matter. The interval probabilities are always going to be the same. Just like the discrete random variables, we can also define the cumulative distribution function for continuous random variables. Just like that, the cumulative distribution function, or the CDF, fx, capital Fx, will be equal to the probability of that continuous random variable to be less than or equal to that arbitrary x value, or simply less than x value, because whether it is going to be equal or not, it's not important. We are rather interested in the probability of the interval. And that interval is an one-sided open interval from minus infinity to x. Therefore, I'm just going to integrate the PDF from minus infinity to x. Now, please be careful. I am especially changing the integral operator to t here because x here is defined as the upper bound. So if you are defining as the upper bound of the integral, then you need to change the integral operator to something else. Still, we are integrating the probability density function from minus infinity to x, which is the area under the curve within that region, and that is the cumulative distribution function. Now, just like the cumulative distribution functions in the discrete random variables case, the CDF is going to be a non-decreasing function of x starting from zero, because on the most left side there will be no cumulative area under the PDF, and when you move to the most right hand side, the total area under the PDF on the left-hand side will be equal to 1. So this is just going to be a non-decreasing function starting from 0, ending at 1. And this time it is going to be a continuous function. In the discrete case, it was a stair-shaped function where we observe some jumps. However, here it is just going to be a continuous function. Now let's solve a question here. We have a continuous random variable x denoting the number of hours that a worker spends to set up a latte machine. So basically x here is measuring a time duration for a certain activity, which is the setup of a latte machine. And that duration has a probability density function, which is defined as 3 over 4 times 2x minus x squared within the 0-2 interval. So because it is measuring in hours, what we understand from here is that random variable is supposed to take any real value between 0 and 2, which means in the worst case, the maximum time to set up the latte machine would be 2 hours, and in the best case, it will be 0 hours. And here we write otherwise 0, which means other than the values in this interval, this random variable cannot take any other value. So the question asks us the probability that the machine can be set up in less than 1 hour, and that is just going to be the probability of the setup time to be less than or equal to 1 hour, which is simply equivalent with the CDF of that random variable at 1. So I'm just going to integrate the PDF from 0 to 1. Actually, for this inequality, I need to integrate my PDF from minus infinity to 1. However, as we know, from minus infinity to 0, the function itself is defined as 0. So whether you integrate it or not, there will be no area accumulated under that function. Therefore, we are basically starting from the lower bound of the possible values that the random variable can take. So from 0 to 1, when we integrate that function, you are going to get this output, and by plugging in the upper bound and lower bound and calculating the difference, you get the probability, which is equal to 1 over 2 in this case. So the probability that this setup process ends less than 1 hour is 1 over 2. Now, just like the discrete random variables, continuous random variables also have an expected value and also a variance. And just like in the discrete random variables case, expected value measures the central tendency of that random variable, where it is trying to be positioned over the real line, is determined by the expected value. In other words, the expected value is the average value. And the variance is a measure of spread, measure of dispersion, or how dispersed the possible values of that random variable over the real line. In order to calculate the expected value of a continuous random variable, we cannot take a weighted average of the possible values that it can take, because the number of possible values that it can take are uncountably many. So what we are going to do is, we are going to multiply x with the PDF, where PDF is an indicator for the relative likeliness of that possible value. And we are multiplying that function with the value itself, and we integrate this from minus infinity to plus infinity. So in that sense, this is just like a weighted average of the possible values that the random variable can take, but the weights are defined as the density values that x assuming. Okay, so we basically integrate x times the PDF from minus infinity to plus infinity, or simply for all possible values of that random variable. Now, the variance is also in a similar fashion, can be calculated as the expected value of x squared minus square of the expectation, or you can use the classical formula. In the classical formula case, again, you need to calculate the expected value first, then you multiply the PDF with x minus the expected value to the power 2, and integrate it from minus infinity to plus infinity, or you first calculate expected value of x squared by multiplying PDF with x squared as an integrand and integrating it from minus infinity to plus infinity, and then you subtract the square of the expectation as calculated previously. Now, for the previous question where we were representing the probability distribution of the setup time of the latte machine with a probability density function, for that one, we are going to compute the expected value and the variance of that random variable. And the expected value would be what? We are going to multiply the PDF with x, and that is going to become our integrand. And we are integrating it between 0 and 2 again, because at everywhere else that integrand would be 0, because the PDF is defined as 0. The integral result here is 1, and this means the average time for setting up this later machine is equal to 1 hour. This is the average time. Now, for variance, we calculate the expected value of x squared, which requires integrating the integrand of x squared times the PDF. So this is basically, this integrand is basically x times the previous integrand. Again, integrating from 0 to 2 yields as 6 over 5, and the variance of x would be equal to expected value of x squared minus square of the expectation, and that becomes 1 over 5. And as we have mentioned about some identities about expectation and variance in discrete random variables, these identities are also valid for continuous random variables as well. So whether we have a discrete or continuous random variable, the expected value of ax plus b, a linear function of a random variable, will always be equal to the linear function of the expectation of that random variable, which means the multiplier term and the increment term can get out of the expectation. However, if you intend to calculate the variance of the linear function of a random variable, in that case, b would not affect anything. However, a, the multiplier term, gets out of the variance by squaring it. So a squared times variance of x would be our result. The proofs are similar to the proofs of the discrete case. You can basically just look at these proofs in the previous pages for the discrete case and apply it for the continuous random variables by yourselves as an exercise.